Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. .46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. Fighting through. Taken down at the 18. So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for Holden. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He sets to fire deep. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. And the defense now for the Eagles.
Fletcher Cox is a first-round pick who has fulfilled his promise, one of the best defensive linemen in the NFL.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Quick hitter here, it's complete. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
Brandon, just marked that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it, no yardage. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. They'll try the right side here with Yeldon. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line. DeMarcus Lawrence.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Jordan Matthews, 35 yards. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. But what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs. If you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you talk about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you've got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this one PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
With about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They're going to look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will be brought Now a play fake here on first down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted. But you know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this punt goes out of bounds and it'll be marked inside the 40. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Here we go. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play. So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And they'll run it here. Room here to run. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Well, certainly running the ball pretty well on this drive. And all I remember as a secondary guy was if you're making a lot of tackles in a game, that's usually not good for your defense. You've got to figure out how to keep things in front of you because you know there's 3 levels, defensive line, linebackers, and into the secondary. And if the third...
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. In a 3-4 defense there and against the run, a lot of responsibility can fall on that nose tackle.
A ton of responsibility, no pun intended, because they got to deal with not just the center, both guards, and a lot of times they have to eat up double teams in order to let the rest of the guys get to the football. But how about that play? He not only eat up the double team, he ate up the ball carrier as well.
I was going to say, talking about puns, you said eat up the double team. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver, 27 yards. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you can just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Shift together here from the D-line.
Watch it now, Barney.
Now T.J. Yeldon. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. And time for us to take a break here in the booth. We'll be back with more in the NFC title bout after this.
Detroit! Back to NFL, here we go. Here we go. Boom, Niners!
They'll set up to throw. And hauled in here by Richard Rodgers. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
And Richard Rodgers makes the grab, and let's face it, it's going to follow him the rest of his career. The Hail Mary he caught to beat the Lions in 2015 in Detroit, pretty memorable play.
Those Lions fans, they just don't like you right now if they heard that.
I didn't mean to bring it up to, you know, pull the Band-Aid off the wound there. I was just trying to...
And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll run it again with Yeldon. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that is going to set up a third and one.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it. And boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup. And guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
They'll look to throw for it on third and one. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. They'll look to throw. That is caught inside the five. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll try and run for it with Yeldon. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches, you say, son, if you could darn near lay that.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Their dangerous wide receiver in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. This one taken from the 7. And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Forced out to his left. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And now, due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
He's got time in the pocket. It got his man complete. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. 75 yards. And the Saints move back within a couple of the lead.
Eagle. Libra. Eagle. Libra.
And on the ground they go with the running back. And he'll get into the end zone, and those 2 points are going to tie the game. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. This one taken from the 7. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
yeah,
they?
When we talked about him, they
did. Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
A gain of 3, second down.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A good pickup there, a 22.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here, 3rd and 1 yard.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1. Now Dan Carpenter to try a field goal here. from the left hash. He'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Carpenter knocks it through, and they take a 17-14 lead. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
Oftentimes, when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical. Spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically. You just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running backs.
Let's go, D.
It's a five-receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Going to throw right side here. Complete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And he puts a little something extra into this one. By far his best of the night. This is fielded at the 7. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. And that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
2nd down now after the incompletion. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. And they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to 2nd and 4.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Looking to throw, and he finds a man on a crossing route. Touchdown, New Orleans! Their dangerous wide receiver, 64 yards. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. Good pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. Took him less time than that to get to top speed and complete that play.
This one taken from the 7. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one.
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here, and they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right, to be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Offense still needing 10 yards, second down.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
The gun now on third down. That is caught inside the five. And he's brought down after a good gain. That one goes for 24 yards.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even at it.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They come out here in the eye. Second and goal from the 2-yard line. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great effort there, taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for six. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. It's a gain of 9 yards, and it'll be second and about a yard. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get
and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. That winds up pushing him back 11 yards on the sack. And that'll bring up third. One receiver left, three to the right. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down.
All right, here we go.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Their dangerous wide receiver. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. Now Carpenter to add the extra point. And the lead is now 24. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here.
I got to trip this side. We got three.
One receiver left, three to the right.
That's it now, Barney.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Blue 90!
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And now here is another interception. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
Here we go with second and 7. They come out here in the eye. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. He needed 3. He got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and 1. And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And that will extend their lead even further. So it's 3 more points, and that widens things out even further here in the 4th.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the 3 whenever you can.
And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Looking right sideline. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll look to throw now on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Time for a break. Back with more in the NFC Championship game after this. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Throws right side, and that's complete. And that one good for 16 yards and a first. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important time.
And my goodness, another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. This was the goal before they started the season, to play in a Super Bowl, and that's exactly what they're doing.
Feeling like Leonardo, let me paint the picture. I might need a bottle on the road to success. I can feel the throttle.